say that our people with. We have grown people still running around and talking about these demons and ward off people's spirits. Nigga, are you stupid? What is wrong with you? See, that's them educated niggas again. Like I said, I had a partner, man, educated nigga, got his degree, belonged to one of them Greek fraternities, which is a lot of homosexuals, if you ask me. And that's okay. See, I don't have no problem talking about homosexuality and stuff. My daughter said, Daddy, you're homophobic. I'm not homophobic, but that's not our culture. And I don't have no problem saying that's not our culture. That is not us. That's why I say be in the world, but not of it. The orders was given to Adam and Eve, do not follow these people from the land of Nod. What was the land of Nod? Our people don't even know that. The land of Nod was the land where you had demonic people that didn't give a damn about God's laws, and they set up the land of Nod after they had the war in heaven and they were cast to the earth. These are the people that set up the land of Nod, and when these gods came to the planet and said, let us make a man in our image and after our likeness, these are the black gods that came here to check on these demons that they cast to the earth after they had the war in heaven. I told this to somebody, they're going to laugh at me. I said, well, you know, it may not be a bad thing to have a goon squad. They said, well, I said, God had a goon squad. They said, man, come on, man. I said, hold on. Didn't God tell Michael and the angels, go down there and check Satan and them's ass, because they're down there getting out of order. Mm-hmm. Michael then went down there and checked Satan and them, said, look, man, y'all out of here, y'all out of order. So then after they didn't listen, they went back and told God, say, you know, Satan, I mean, listen, so, okay, do what you got to do. They went back, started whooping Satan's ass. They had a war in heaven. They cast them to the earth. These are the beings that set up the land of Nod. Now these beings came to the planet and they created another man. Adam and Eve was created and their orders was do not follow these people from the land of Nod. The land of Nod was the people that when Cain killed his brother and he was cast to the land of Nod, what did he say in the third chapter of Genesis? I don't want to go over there because somebody might see me and they'll kill me. Well, if they were the first people, who are the people in the land of Nod? So when he was cast to the land of Nod, he met a man named Lamech, who had two wives, Ida and Zillah. Where did they come from? So when they got cast to the earth, they brought their women with them. These people were not created in the land in the Garden of Eden. These are the things that we have to start coming to grips with. What do you call a nigga that you don't trust? A snake. This was the snake that creeped into the Garden of Eden and whispered into Eve's ear, but this snake told her the truth at the beginning because she said, we can't eat from that tree or we'll die. He said, no, that's a lie. You'll surely not die. Didn't he say that? Yes. Go read that for yourself. So that means the devil, the serpent, that the snake who whispered in Eve's ear told her the truth in the garden. No, you ain't going to die. There's no such thing as death. That's what Jesus taught. It's these Caucasians that flip the script on us and teaching us death and dying because they can only control us through the fear of death. When you don't have a fear of death, they can't control us. And that's what they're afraid of. They have to keep us with that fear. So the point is, you have to know the story. And the orders were stop following these people from the land of Nod. These were devils and devil spirits that were in human flesh in the land of Nod, doing all kind of wicked things. And then up to the flood, the people didn't listen. They started following them anyway. What happened? The flood came. After the flood, it says that Satan and his beings left the planet, went to the sixth star system, Saturn. After the flood, they came back from the sixth star Saturn and set up shop in Sodom and Gomorrah. That's why Sodom and Gomorrah was destroyed. These beings have always, see, that's what we ain't getting. Devils are people. Devils are a race of people. They're not the red man with a pitchfork on a hot sauce bottle. And that's what we got to get out of. Do you remember, did you look at that movie, James Brown's story? Little Richard said something to James Brown in that movie, and I don't know how many people got it, but I got it right away. James Brown was sitting there, and Little Richard said, James, and that's when the devil going to come. And he ain't going to be no red man with a tail and a pitchfork. He going to be white in a fancy suit. These are the devils on the planet. Walking around here wearing Armani suits, carrying briefcases, riding in Rolls Royces. I worked for some of the richest people and wealthiest people in all of Atlanta. It was always something very eerie about these people. And I used to tell my mother, I said, Mama, you know what? If these people said, Matt, you know, come over to our house for dinner tonight. I said, don't you know, Mom, I wouldn't feel comfortable about going. And if I did go, I would have to have a Uzi or something in my coat. And I said, because if they don't try to have a blood sacrifice up in there, it's going to be the other terror cat. I said, I just don't trust it. And I told her that. She thought I was joking. But I'm going to tell you something. There are many people that have come up missing because a devil rolled up in a Rolls Royce and offered them a ride. And took them to their big old castle house. And if you were never seen from or heard from again, I'm telling you, this is real. The Queen of England, the Vatican, the Pope, who you all love. I saw a nigga had his head on a Pope's shoulder. That nigga hugged the Pope. You could have swore Jesus was came to earth. And I'm going to tell you, this was the Honorable Elijah Muhammad's son, Ward D. Muhammad. No disrespect, but I'm telling you, when Ward D. Muhammad approached the Pope, you got to look in his eyes, the way he was elated, that the way he laid his head on his shoulder, this is truth and facts. And I'm telling you, everybody that takes office got to kiss the Pope's hand. The only one president that didn't kiss his hand was President Kennedy, and you saw what happened to him. But I'm under the impression that if you kiss a man's hand, you kiss his ass. If you kiss his ass, you do something else. And that's what they want you to think. That's what it's all about. They are pushing their homosexual agenda. They are pushing their homosexual agenda on us. And again, this is not our culture. So our orders are, do not follow these people from the land of Nod. They have taken the earth and all of America, and they have turned every city into the land of Nod. And with that new Supreme Court ruling, now America is the new land of Nod. And we're living in the land of Nod amongst all these people. What did they do in the land of Nod? They had bright lights and fancy shows and girls running around here wearing their stuff and walking down the street the way these girls walk down there, showing their titties and walking around with tights or pants where you can see right through them and see the ass. I mean, this is the way they was doing things in the land of Nod. They was tattooing their whole bodies up and everything. You don't have a clue what's really going on. All of these things came from the people whose origins are from the old land of Nod. But because we look at it like, oh, those are ancient times. No, nigga, this is happening today. And I'm going to say this for those niggas that are sensitive to the word nigga. I got to say this. I always got to say it. I had a lady call me from the show who called me and said, I just saw your program on Pan TV. Are you crazy? She was having a fit. I said, what's wrong, sis? You using the word, the N-word, and you talking about Jesus, why using the N-word? And I said, sister, calm down. I said, and she wouldn't let me talk. So I said, okay, God bless you. So let me just say this for those that might feel like she feel. Jesus came from the bloodline of a holy seed of Abraham. In the book Acts 13:1, Barnabas was Jesus' brother. In the Acts 13:1, in the land of Antioch, you had certain prophets such as Barnabas and Simeon, his two brothers, who were called nigger. Now I had an educated nigger that was with. He said, no, Mac, he looked it up. That's Niger, because they had one G. I said, read that carefully, man. It said they were called this. Have you ever been called a Niger nigger? What is wrong with you? So these are the things that we have to come to grips with. Now, if Simon and Barnabas were called nigger, that means that Mary was a nigger, Jesus was a nigger, Joseph, all the disciples were niggers. That means that I could have walked up and down the street 2,000 years ago. If nigger wasn't a bad word then it's not a bad word now. Somebody took that word because they know that we are the bloodline of these same people, and they turned it into something bad. 2,000 years ago, that mean that I could have been walking down the street and ran to Barnabas and Simeon. Barnabas, Simeon, what's up, nigga? What you want to share that so people don't get offended by that word? It's not a bad word. It really not. And you had the NAACP that went down to Florida. Listen to this one. They went down to Florida to have a burial for the N-word. I mean, they had a coffin and everything and had a burial for the N-word. Well, I wrote this article called The Evolution of the Nigger, the Holy Seed of Abraham, and in that article I said what them niggas ought to be doing is bearing that damn Spingarn Award that they give out every year at the NAACP Awards. Listen to this. This is the ignorance that we're dealing with. While they down there bearing a word that they don't know nothing about, at the NAACP Awards, the most prestigious award given at the NAACP Awards is called the Spingarn Award. Joel Spingarn was the Jew traitor that turned everybody's names in to the FBI who started the NAACP. And they got a prestigious award behind this crap. This is the kind of ignorance that we are dealing with, and this is the kind of ignorance that we got to shed light on so we can bring truth and facts to the table. Damn that shit that them NAACP is talking about. They're a traitor organization too. Everybody telling that Jesus died for their sin, they're all the same problem. Everybody that's telling that story, and any minister that know about the Council of Nicaea in 325 AD, know damn well that they took these books out. They inserted all the books of Paul. They took the story away from Jesus leading us to the Father, and they put in the books of Paul and led us to Jesus. When Jesus personally said, you are not supposed to worship me. When they called him good master, what did he say? There's none that's good but the Father. He did everything in his power to lead us to the Father. He said, y'all got to get up. Y'all going to get me in trouble when I go back home. So when he got back to where his galaxy is from, you know, up there, they like, you know what, people down there worshiping you. He said, oh, y'all saw, I told them niggas don't worship me. When I left, they started doing it anyway. So I'm guiltless of that. So you don't even understand what's going on. He led us to the Father. They led us to him. And they gave us a wrong name. Jesus, not his name. If you was walking down the street and you hollered Jesus, he ain't got no reason to turn around. If I'm walking down the street, somebody go, Anthony, I ain't got no reason to turn around. My name is Matt. So the point is, we are worshiping and calling on the name of a false god and don't even know it. These devils know what they're doing. We have been reduced to the mentality of beasts, where they led and fed us all of this false doctrine. And to the point that the door to our common sense have been completely closed. The truth will set and make us free, not the lie. We have been telling that lie since the slave master gave it to us. When we start telling the truth, that truth is going to make us free as a people. We are in bad shape. We are in trouble. And if we stop telling, can you imagine if all of the black churches at one time start saying, you know what, the slave master lied to us. Jesus didn't die for our sins. That brother came here to give us some information. And he came looking for brothers in hood. You got to know what's happening. This is the same period of time, a different year. When he was born when they had all of the Europeans, the Romans and the white Jews, the Caucasian Jews, over the land of Judea, the land of the black people. Jesus was born into that day and time. He was talking to brothers in the hood, the lost sheep, the gangsters, the pimp, the hoes, the dope dealers, whatever they were called the lost sheep. So if he came today, he would be born and walking through the people in the hood. He ain't come to no intellectuals. He didn't come to none of them because he said, those that are healed don't need a physician. He came looking for the lost sheep and the lost sheep only. And that's who we are after, the lost sheep, to wake them up. The church is being used to keep our people asleep with that story that Jesus died for our sins. That is not true. That is an outright lie. He came to teach us how to find the kingdom within you so you can be connected to that spirit within, so you don't keep saying, man, something told me to do that. Something told me not to do that. They disconnected you from that. And they put their teaching in a Smithsonian Institute called the Divine Communication of Silence. They know the power of silence. That's why they got so much going on. Entertainment, games, etc., etc. Anything but leading you into the silence. That's why the scriptures say, in the sacred place of the Most High. Where's that sacred place at? In that silence. And he taught the science of creation. Everything you're going to ever get on this planet can only come through what you think, what you say, and what you do. You are the creation and the creator of your life. When the Most High blew his breath in us, he gave us the ability to do the exact same thing. He created us with his thought, with the word, and with his action. And everything you do gonna come through what you think, say, and do. You thinking and talking about it, being a gangster, that's what you're gonna be. You talking about it, thinking about it, and talking about doing whatever. This is how it's being done, through your own creation. And when you know this for a fact, then you can go back and start meditating, going within and get connected.